Hello everyone! Happy September! It's Jennifer here again from RE/MAX Partners, bringing you the most up-to-date real estate updates in your neighborhood. How's everyone doing? It's the second week of September. It was the first week of school for my kids last week. The house is finally quiet again. No more feeling guilty about what to do with them for the summer. Anyways, my kids were super excited about going back to school, so I can say it's a win-win situation for both kids and parents. As for myself, it's been a busy summer. Like all working parents, balancing work and squeezing in the time to spend with the family. Since my kids are teens, we did a lot of patio and roadside eating. The picture at the bottom is us eating on the roadside at Young and Shepherd. Had to pick up a check for my client, so I mixed business with pleasure. The food was great, and I don't know if I would do it again because I was worried the whole time about getting hit by a car. So it was a great experience. My kids loved it. I think it's because of the thrill, but it was definitely different. On the top left was a beautiful spot on Lake Scugog. Had a picnic and some fishing there. Weather was great. We did zero planning for that trip. It was basically my sister calling me the morning of, and I just basically grabbed all the snacks I can find in the house and off we went. Sometimes I think the best times you can have is the other ones that you didn't really plan for and just went and go with it. Enough about myself. Let's jump into real estate. Okay, let's look at the GTA numbers. We had a total of 8,596 transactions in GTA for the month of August. That is a total of 19.9, almost 20% drop from last year. This drop is mainly due to all-time low new listings that are coming out on the market. Check this out. Our new listings is down 43% from a year ago. If you look at sales to new listings ratio, it's actually 81%. This means every 10 listings out, 8 of them are sold, as compared to last year, which was just 58%. So when you have high demand and only a few listings, what happens? The answer, price naturally goes up. Price went up 12.6% last month, year over year. From 950K to 1.07, that is over $100,000 increase. Seasonally, price continues to go up from July, up another 2.4%. Now, how does your neighborhood Rouge Woods compare to Richmond Hill? Well, we've only sold 7 homes in the whole month of August. That's because there were really only a handful of homes available at any given time. Only 2 detached homes sold last month, giving us an average of 1.69, close to $1.7 million. This average, however, is up 10% from last year. 2 semi-detached homes sold in August, giving an average of $1.378 million. I just want to mention that one of these semi-detached sold on Crescendo was over 2,000 square foot corner lot and was totally renovated, which in the end sold over $1.4 million. 3 townhouses sold last month and average price was $1.16 million. This is up 17% from last year. So currently we have 16 active listings. Have to say, quite a bit came out in the last week or so. This is seasonally typical as summer is over and sellers or parents are refocusing back to their big plans of moving before the winter. Days on the market is extremely healthy, which is at 11 days. This is how long it takes for a home to sell in your area. So overall, the market is still doing really, really well for sellers. Give us a call if you are thinking of selling and we can sit down and have a quick chat on how we can help you get your home sold for top dollars. Next, I want to go over some of the frequently asked questions that were asked by my clients. Will the market cool down once new housing or home buying policies are enforced after the election? I'm getting this question quite a lot from my buyers, mainly. Needless to say, buyers are having a tough time buying anything in this market. So naturally, they want a break and hopes for a decline in price so they can buy. My take on any incentives to first home buyers is that they're great. I don't think, however, they will be enough to make buying that much easier. So, what about the banning of foreign ownership? The banning will stop a very few percentage of the buyers. In my 16 years in business, foreign buyers hold a very, very small percentage in my business. So, I'm not convinced that this will affect or slow down the price negatively at all, especially immigration numbers are in hundreds of thousands. These are not foreigners. They will buy a home when they come here because they do need to settle down with their family and start their new lives. Last question. What about ending blind bidding? That's a big one. Personally, I'm for it. I'm for ending blind bidding. I don't think it's healthy for home prices to go up so quickly in such a short time. I work with both sellers and buyers. I see the pain the buyers go through to get a home. I think by ending blind biddings will provide definitely more transparency to the home buying process. And I think it's only fair. I don't think ending blind bidding will bring down the prices, however. I do think that it will slow down the market and a rise in prices will be more reasonable. That's it for our monthly updates. Please reach out if you have any questions about your property or want to receive a free home evaluation of your home. We'll be more than happy to help. Until next time, please stay safe and take care.